This time on Fire Emblem Path of Radiance. Hey guys, Raiden here, and welcome to my new series, Fire Emblem Path of Radiance. Now, some of you guys don't even know that I like Fire Emblem, but I happen to like it a lot. To this day, I have played FE7, Sacred Stones, almost both versions of Fates, I'm nearing the end of Conquest, and Awakening. So I played my fair share of Fire Emblem games, and I'm a pretty large fan. I never got to finish Path of Radiance, because it was actually stolen from me, which is not fun. But I think I remember roughly up to chapter 10. After that, it's blind. So, can't wait to get this started. In case you just want to know what I kind of do on my channel real quick, I play RPGs in sometimes strategy games like XCOM. I'm going to not let that play because frame rate's not so great in that. And I really just like to get involved with the story and see what the characters do. And Fire Emblem has some of my favorite characters and story just in video games. So, without further ado, let's get started. I want to know about the man who fights for his friends. As I've heard. Yeah, I had a chapter going for my test recording. I don't really remember the game too well in itself, but we'll figure it out. So, yeah. You can see I was doing the prologue. So it has three difficulties. It has easy, normal, and difficult. From what I understand, I looked this up, and the difficulty, I would normally just go for the hardest one, but it apparently raises enemy health, or enemy health values, and decreases earned XP. So, I wouldn't want to do that just because I want to get as many people as possible to go on to the next section of their class to get their promotion and not be stuck in their first generation forever. So we're going to go with normal, because I do like a decent challenge. I usually play like the later games on Lunatic and the earlier games on whatever difficulty, but for LP purposes, we're going to play this on normal. Alright, let's get started.
Well, Ike? You had enough?
Dad! Ike!
Oh, missed.
That song.
Ah, you're up. About time.
So, this is kind of weird because the voice acting for Ike is fine. I already know his name. And that guy that I remember being his father, I don't remember his name. Their voice acting is fine, but you get to whoever she was. I think it was Ike's, like, sister, if I recall. I don't remember. But, you get to her, and her voice acting's just, ugh. So, I don't know how to do female voices. You can hear that I obviously have too deep of a voice for female voices. I'll try to do as much as I can, but I'm just gonna give them my normal voice. Are you alright? Yeah, I'll be fine. So, the sleeping prince awakens. Father, I can't believe you. I know those are practice swords, but they're still heavy, and you have no right to be so rough on Ike. If he doesn't now, he will die. Like, he does. This is too much for the boy. He'll never make it as a mercenary. But... Mist, you don't have to worry. I told you I'm fine. Ah, you better be. I don't know why he has such a nasally voice. Maybe it's his ridiculously long nose. Now grab your sword and get ready. What? Don't tell me you're going at it again, but... Just until I land a single blow. I'm not giving up till I can hit... Well, I'm not giving up until I can get one good hit on Father. Regardless of if he's looking or not. Regardless of if it's at the dinner table. I like your resolve, Ike. But it takes more than just a strong will to... Aha! I knew I'd find you here. Hi, Boyd. What brings you here? Nothing special. You said you were going to get the boss, but you never came back. I got picked to check up on you. Oh, sorry. I got caught up with Ike and my father. It's nothing. Besides, I figured I'd get a good laugh watching Ike get worked over by the boss. Wow. Thank you. If I recall correctly, best friend. You are so supportive. You look fine. What happened? Nothing. Nothing at all. I won. You stood no chance. And I'm gonna become leader of the Band of the Hawk. I mean, the hell is Ike's troop even called? You just missed it. Just a minute ago, he was out cold. Miss, don't tell him that. Huh, sorry. You came at just the right time, Boyd. You can be Ike's sparring partner. What? But me? I'm beginning to think it would be better if he sparred with someone closer to his own skill. I gotta speed up, like, the text appearance. I'm sure we can do that. I understand. Father, I won't let you down. Thanks for the help, Boyd. I don't know why he's Solid Snake now. I don't know about this closer to his skill business, but I'm ready. So, the thing I messed up on a lot in this section. Alright, I'm ready for you. Let's go! Yeah! So, the thing I messed up quite a bit on in this section is... We're not going to do a tutorial because it's basic Fire Emblem. I'm going to explain some things to you guys so I don't have to do it all over again. Because I also like people to learn about the game and how things work. So, one thing, the very first thing I noticed, and unless I'm wrong, and there is no, like, push a button and you can see all enemy attack ranges at once. There's not that. It's weird because some of the older games had that, I believe. It's been a while since I've even played Sacred Stones, but I strongly believe they had that. You have to manually go to them and see what their movement and hit ranges are, which isn't as bad, but... Anyways, we can see what weapons they have. We have a weapon called a trainer, which I'm assuming does not do killing blows. We don't just go around camps killing people. What does he have? Oh, he's a practice axe. Alright. Let's see. Let's look at this menu. Okay, so Ike is a level 1 ranger. I don't believe that class is in any other Fire Emblem game. I don't know. I don't recall seeing it anywhere. He's 0 XP, 19 health. His starting stats are 5 strength, 1 magic. Why'd they even bother giving him magic? I don't think you can... Yeah, this class is... Or this game doesn't have reclassing, so it's kind of weird. He has 6 skills, 7 speed, 6 luck, and 5 defense with 0 resistance. We better not put him around some mages. Let's see what's on this page. He has a movement of 6. That's above average. And a weight of 9. Whatever that does. Build 9, I actually have no clue what that means. We can actually look with this. The unit's body size helps determine the unit's weight. Oh yeah, I forgot. Path of Radiance has some very special movement things like shove and other things like that. We'll get to them eventually, and it actually depends on how heavy your unit is and what their build is. It's just telling you his race because there are several races in this game. He's Bjork, which just basically means human. So these are the skill sections. He doesn't have anything right now. And lastly, he has a weapon level D for swords. I have no idea what half of this stuff is. So, I don't know what this attribute system does. I'm very new to this. The divine protection this unit receives, this affects its affinity with other units. Okay, so that's something to do with the support system. We have a biorhythm. I've never seen this before. The unit's biorhythm, when the marker is high, the unit performs better. When it is low, the unit suffers penalties. I assume that leads to, like, missed hit and extra critical chance, depending on, like, if they keep taking damage every... I don't know. I don't know what that causes that. And what are these two stats? The name of the unit traveling... Okay, so if you have some... So if you're protecting someone, that'll be their name. The unit's current condition. Alright, well, I think that's all the info we need to know. So first thing I actually tried doing is I tried doing the smart Fire Emblem player thing, and I tried, hey, I'm gonna just move around and bait him so he walks towards us, because if I walk towards him now, he's gonna hit us. But if you do that, all they kind of do is yell at you like, hey, what's the holdup? Let's get started already. I'm coming. Wait right there. So we do have to walk manually over there. Normally this would get us hit and we'd lose the fight, but tutorial. So now he's just gonna stare at me. Hurry up, will you? Or are you afraid of me? I'm not afraid of you. So yeah, this is the shove command. This isn't in any other game, except for maybe Radiant Dawn, which I also haven't played. Basically, if you push it, you can shove an enemy or ally even, I believe, one tile. So that's pretty nice. I wish they kind of would bring that back. I think they brought it back later as a barbarian specific skill. Not barbarian, but like a warrior. Anyways. So the downside to this game I noticed is I think the combat animations are the most bland and dull in the series, but I don't mind. You can do it! Boyd's got nothing! Take him out! Nothing? Wow, that's real nice. I don't have nothing. I mean, I have this headband. I have this green head of hair. Matches my eyes. I mean, see, look how rigid that axe swing was. Like, what was that? He just twirled around his entire arm. Haha, I'm not done yet. We're just getting started, are we? Well, I guess I'll have to hit you again. So I think Ike's stance is actually unique. He has the one arm out in front and the sword raised above his head. Which kind of makes sense a little. There are various one-handed sword styles without a shield, so... That wasn't too bad. Boyd, you're such a loser. Wow. Okay. Shut your trap. Good work, Boyd. That's enough. Oh, alright. That's right. Get out of here. Your swordsmanship was decent enough, Ike. Don't forget how it felt. It won't always be this easy. I know. Now that you're done warming up, it is time for you to face me again. Again? I was hoping you'd say that. But first, miss? Right here. Oh, is she going to heal us or something? Here you go, Ike. It's a vulnerary. Ah, perfect. How do you actually say that? Vulnerary? I just call them vulneraries. I'd recommend using it now, before you fight Father. Last time, he knocked you out silly. Or he knocked you silly. Well, last time, he was playing cheap. Ike, you tried to hit me while I wasn't looking. That's not cheap. Strategical advantage. Always take time to heal your wounds, even in battle, even the small ones. By the time you think you're in trouble, it's probably too late. Don't get into that situation. So, are we supposed to... Yeah, we're supposed to heal ourselves. What's his attack range? I don't want to get hit. I imagine he's going to charge us. I heard the AI in this game is... What? Get ready, Ike. Here I come. I imagine his attack range is actually infinite. Oh, you know what it is? I just didn't move far enough. Although I'm fine with this outcome because I can kind of see how much... He doesn't do that much damage. What I should have done... Come on, boy, you're going to give me a challenge this time around? I should have looked at what his actual movement stat is. I bet it's ridiculous. He can move 7 spaces. If I hit over... No, I don't think there's anywhere I can go. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7... No, I just walked into it. If I walked over here, he couldn't... have gotten us. Oh well. Let's just finish our job. Oh, he won't kill us next turn. Unless he crits somehow. I've done a Fire Emblem 7 randomized run, and that's hilarious. Oh, one health left. Damn. Ugh. So, we are gonna get our first level up, so I heard Ike's growth rates are insanity. That's pretty damn good. I don't know what a ranger is supposed to excel at, but I just don't know. Ike, you were great. Father, were you holding back? You were, weren't you? Ike, if I wasn't holding back, you would be dead right now. What? Is that true? If you could tell the difference, that means you're improving. That is very true. That applies to all martial arts. Here's the classic screen. You know, I wasn't really giving it my all either. That is such a lie. Bah. Well, I mean, he does have the short end of the stick on the weapon triangle. So, Father, does that mean you finally admit that I'm ready? What? Join the company? To take on a job? Yeah. I mean, Boyd's already out there on the battlefield, and I just beat him. I'm ready. I'm tired of being a trainee. Listen, the difference between you and me is that I'm a professional. A professional who just got beat. Wow, this girl just loves burning people. That was just random chance. That's how I got through Conquest on Lunatic. So far, it's just RNG. You got a point, Ike. Alright, tomorrow will be your first day as a full-fledged mercenary. Really? But, if I think that's too much, you're back to trainee status. You better work hard. No problem, Dad. Watch, I'll catch up to everyone in no time. We'll see. We'd better get heading back to the fort. Everyone's waiting. I doubt he's supposed to sound like that. I think he's supposed to sound like, you know, mighty and like a true leader. Oops, I just bumped the microphone. That's something I should do in the first episode. But like, his long nose just makes me think he sounds so nasally. So if you are also new to my channel, these episodes are usually around an hour at a time. Yup, that memory card was wrote on my totally legit copy of Path of Radiance. Good morning, Ike. Today's your first day as a professional soldier, isn't it? Yeah, and I'm ready to go. The text is just moving so slowly, it's causing these weird breaks. So, I remember Titania, which is the woman right there, and she is a god unit. She is a pre-promote, and she's actually worth using. She is, like, one of those few pre-promotes like Seth and Camilla, where you're just like, I could use this person the whole game, and I could just win. What you are is late. The others were suited up and ready to ready at the break of dawn. Jeez. Sorry. I'll get up earlier from now on. So what's my first job? I'm talking with Titania right now. Wait outside until we're done. I think he needs to get a cat out of a tree. I forgot to go grocery shopping. Just send him over there and tell them everyone there is a barbarian or something. Yes, sir. Very well, Commander Greil. Shall we continue? You were telling me about some bandits that needed taken care of, weren't you? Correct. The request comes from a nearby village. According to our reports, the bandits are not all that strong. Well, who could have reported that? Did someone walk over there, stab one, and be like, wow, these guys are plebeians? I think it's best if I ride out and take a look. I plan on taking Oscar and Boyd along with me. Just the brothers, hmm? Go ahead and add Ike to your team. Shinon, Gatry, and I can handle the other two jobs easily enough. Titania, I'm leaving Ike in your care, trusting you to show him the ropes. Understood, Commander. Come on, Ike, let's get you set up. Alright, it's my first job. Captain Titania, preparations are complete, and I'm ready to go. Impeccable timing. It's nice to know that we can always count on you to be ready, Oscar. Oh god, it's another squinty eyes. It's weird because that's just become a thing, over the years, just like character designs. It's like, there's one guy that never opens his eyes, and when he opens his eyes, it's getting real. Don't forget about me, I'm ready for action! Is that so, Boyd? That's a surprise. Huh, not today it is. Not today, does that mean you just mess up every day? As of today, I'm going to be the absolute model of perfection. I need to set a good example for Ike. I'll take your word for it. Your first campaign at last. I don't know, what kind of voice? He seems like he'd have, like, a calm, like, slightly above you voice. Like, I don't know. I know you wanted this for a while. Are you nervous, Ike? I think I was more nervous last night. I could hardly sleep. This morning, I'm feeling pretty good. It's the calm before the storm. You should try to relax. You're not going to be out there alone. Yeah, you're right. I have my friends! That was actually my ringtone. That's professional. Right, everyone ready? Let's go. There we go. Wow. I mean, I've seen starter Fire Emblem levels, but I think in terms of, like, a lack of difficulty, this one might take the cake. Although, we do only have 4 units. Alright, let me explain what's going on. This is a map of Caldea. They've hired us to drive off some bandits. Where are the blue marks here? Wow, didn't know that. The red dots are the bandits. There aren't many of them, but we can't get careless. The one in front of the building up north is our leader. How threatening. Our mission is to take him out and recapture that building. Ike, listen up. All this stuff is old news to me, but I can give a rookie like you a few tips. First, get really, really used to killing people. I'll introduce you to this girl named Perry. She knows what I'm talking about. Or maybe Henry. First off, don't let yourself get worked up and jump out in front of everyone. You'll just end up getting hurt. Don't try to do too much, Ike. When things get dangerous, you can and should rely on us. As long as you watch how the enemy moves carefully, you'll be fine. Think of this as a training mission. I'll do that. Oscar, Boyd, thanks for your help. Don't mention it. Just sit back and watch how a professional does things. Enough chit-chat, you three. We've got work to do. Oh, right, our first actual chapter of gameplay. Ike, before you engage an enemy, take a good look at his weapon. The weapon you use often determines who has the upper hand in the fight. Oh yeah, because the weapon triangle. For example, axes beat spears, spears beat swords, and swords beat axes. Yep, how great. Oh, something else? One more thing. So the open doors are the local houses. Don't forget to visit the locals. We're here to help. After all, the villagers should welcome our presence. Alright, well, I'd love to save these villagers. Let's just see how much damage Ike can do. Because I want to start getting Ike and Boyd trained. Why does... What is this? Who decided this? It's like, Ike, you can take a single sword from the barrel. It's like, it just shows Ike carrying out the entire barrel of swords in the background. Why do you have 4 iron swords? That's ridiculousness. Okay, so he can hit 2 8s, so he will not kill his target. So what we can do instead is, let's see. I believe Oscar will survive a hit from anything. Axes may beat him, but hey. Let's see, he'll only take 5 damage from this fight, and he'll hit 2 8s. Like, that animation for the horse riding even, ugh. Like, the cavalier animation is just so stiff and nothing. I'm gonna move Titania back here just in case, like, Boyd starts running into trouble. I'm going to have Boyd start hitting this guy. The only reason I didn't hit that guy with Titania is I think she'd kill him. I didn't really check. I probably should have, but hey. Oh, nope, we got lucky. Ike, there we go. It's time to kill your first person. Are you ready for this? All right. What's going on out there? Is there some sort of army? Pah, a bunch of mercenaries looking for the next meal. The villagers must have hired them. Listen up, lads. Hurt them and hurt them bad. We let this bunch live and we'll have hordes of hired swords hounding us for the rest of our days. You guys don't even realize- oh, that's a real bandit right there. It's those fool villagers. They think they can buy a bunch of cell swords and chase us away? It ain't gonna work out how they wanted. All they get for their troubles is a bunch of ruined houses. Tear them down, boys, that'll teach them. Oh yeah, so, in this game, I remember that was the one most annoying thing, is that barbarians just destroy houses more than anything. Oh shit, that was a crit. Although, it's still nothing like the old ones, like, ugh. Like, the animations just don't match up to the old ones or the new ones. Alright, it's gonna go after Oscar. Oscar has the advantage over him, but I'm still gonna let the XP, I don't know, because Oscar's just a cavalier, but what level is he? Oscar is a Lance Knight. I'm gonna have to look up if that's a pre-promote or not. So if it is, I'm not gonna, like, I probably won't use him too much. I don't know, because we're gonna have to use him, but still. If it's a pre-promote, then I won't, like, shove a bunch of XP on him, but if a Lance Knight is just a level 1 thing, I don't know, it sounds like it would be a pre-promoted class, but I just don't know. So I'm gonna give this kill to Ike. Let's see. Ike, come on, you only hit 7. Well, then there's no way to really do this except to have... What about Boyd? Doesn't he have a throwing axe? No, he doesn't. Maybe I should give Boyd the kill. Yeah, let's just give it to Boyd. It'll avoid some damage. That is if he hits them. Boyd, are you just... critting all over the place? What is with you? Oh no. Oh no 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 no. Visit that house. Since those bandits took over, we can't even sleep at night. Please, help us save our village. Look at that face of caring. He doesn't even look like he's mentally there. Here, my mother left me this. I hope it serves you well. Oh, a seraph robe. Wonderful. I'm gonna move back a few spaces in hopes that he won't be able to... What's his movement? 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5... Okay, yeah, he's in stand a chance. And I believe we missed a house back here. You know what? I'll have Titania go and get it. Because I don't want to give up any of Ike's iron swords, because I know we're going to have to. If we pick up an item, so we have sent in Titania. Titania, that's her name. Ah, you're with the mercenaries, right? Thank you for coming. We've heard a lot about you. Here, take this weapon! We're farmers, not fighters. Maybe I'll get some use from it. Thank you. Although, she can't use this. I'm not gonna trade out the... Actually, you know what? I will. There we go. Now Ike has a steel sword, too. My work here is done, this house is totaled. Time to move to bigger things. Now I'll smash some mercenaries. I feel like I'm kind of overcalculating for the difficulty of this. Okay, let's see. Boyd has gained a bit of XP. We're fighting 2 axe units. I'm gonna do. I'm gonna have. I'm trying not to use Titania at all, basically. I have him do this. He'll survive another hit or two. And now, if Boyd hits, he will get the kill. He can stay. Causing him to probably level up, I believe. He has an 87% chance to hit this time. Better than the 60s he was getting before. There we go. It's a shame, because Boyd is a warrior. I believe I'd have to take a... Oh, come on. That's a little ridiculous. I'll just have him hit someone in the side, but not take the kill. Let's see. Swords beat axes, so let's just move over here. Good, taken care of. Woo! Is that because Ike had two attacks, or is that a skill? And he leveled up again. RNGesus is being very kind to us. Very, very kind. I believe on my first run of this game, I actually had to quit at Chapter 11 once again. Because the stat growths were just not good. They were just flat out bad. Like, I believe Boyd had 4 magic, and he only has a 5% growth rate on magic, so... By the way, when I keep talking about growth rates, how Fire Emblem levels basically work is you have a growth rate for every stat. The growth rate varies from character to character, but say, Boyd has a growth rate of 65 for strength or something. I think that's his actual growth rate. But he has a growth rate of 65. It rolls a random number. It's an RNG random number generator from 1 to 100. If it gets within that 65 percentile, then he will gain a single stat point in strength. If it misses, then he will not get anything for that level. It's very important to consider when you're playing these games. All right. I don't think this guy will run out and hit us, or else he'll run out and hit Boyd this turn, which is fine by me. This guy, we can actually hit him through the fence. I want to kind of test out his aggro range. So, Oscar's a little not great right now. Let's see, what would happen? I don't know what would happen if Ike would fight him. What would happen if Titania would fight him? What are his stats anyways? Whoops. Missed that completely. Hopefully there's something for faster moving units, or like something I can change. So that would kill him. I was hoping we could weaken him, but... Let's see. Alright. Ike can take one hit. I'm gonna give him a vulnerary just in case. Okay, now we just end our turn and see if the boss man is... No. I think he actually will not aggro unless we provoke him. So, I'm not going to do that, and we're just going to run over here. I don't think we're going to run out of vulneraries. I'm not really afraid of that. I haven't had that ever happen before. Ike is just really, really fast now. I think it's because he got those 2 speed level ups in a row. Alright, well then. I'll have him take the last hit. And then we'll have to move on to Mr. Barbarian. I promise it's going to get more exciting later on. This is just the first level of Path of Radiance. Of course, it's going to be a bit of a bore, but... Not what you can do. It's trying to teach people the mechanics. So, this is something I do not like. Oh, is it another iron sword? I guess we'll throw away this one then. So that's something I really don't like about this game, is that if you pick up an item and you don't have room for it, you have to send it to the convoy. Or you don't send it to the convoy, you... Ike, I'm gonna take some of these iron swords off of you. There we go. You just gotta throw them away, and that kinda sucks, to be honest. Why give Ike 4 iron swords at the start of the game? If, like, new players are gonna fight everyone with Ike and they're just gonna throw away the weapons. It's weird. Unless you can actually keep them, and I'm freaking out about nothing. Which is most likely the case. We have a distinct disadvantage here, but he won't be able to kill us, because he can't crit. So. You looking for something, fool? You looking for a fight? No, we came here and slaughtered every one of your men because we're just... I don't know, what, going for a stroll? Heh. You came to the right place. I'll give you a tussle. That's a creepy voice. I'll just have him stay there, because I kind of want him to get hit next turn. Okay, so that is regenerating seize points. Which isn't bad, because it's only 2 health. I just wish Boyd had a throwing axe to make this a bit easier on us. So, Ike being the main character, I imagine he'd be a bit easier to level than Boyd, so we're gonna have to... I kind of want Boyd to get this kill. So you can move after you hit someone. I'm not sure exactly how that's supposed to work. Let's see, 11 for 9. Boyd has 23 health, so he'll be fine, and he'll actually kill him next turn. If he lands the hit. There we go. Oh! Alright then, I think we've done this. Unless... No more houses. We didn't miss any. I just wanted to make sure. I don't believe this one was salvageable in any way. I'm not gonna go back for salvage houses. Like, I think this isn't going to be an Iron Man run, because that's just not how I play Fire Emblem. That's how I play XCOM on near hardest difficulty Iron Man. But Fire Emblem, like, the characters are just too important, so if a character does die, I'll restart the level, but I'll cut it so you don't have to so you guys don't have to watch the entire thing again. But you guys will see when I lose. You will see my frustration. Ugh. I meant for better than this. I don't want to die here. Well, then why are you a goddamn barbarian bandit? You're meant for better than this. Why don't you just go to a sewing class or something? Do something productive with your life. Oh, that was quite the bit of XP. Well, now Boyd is level 4. I'm gonna... No, that wasn't such a good one, but defense is nice, and HP is also nice. As long as he's not getting points thrown into magic constantly. Let's have Ike seize the throne. That's the end of it. Ike, are you alright?
Yeah, I'll be fine.
You know, you surprise me to think you've come so far.
Look at my father, though. We've still got such a long way to go.
There's nothing you can do about that. After all, Commander Greil has killed so many people, you wouldn't even know.
Huh? What about my father?
Oh, nothing. Nothing? Now I'm really curious. Don't worry, you'll learn about it all someday.
Ellipsis.
Hey, Ike. That wasn't bad for your first battle. Not as flashy as my first time, though. Yeah, when I ran into the village, saw the guy, wet my pants, left, and I paid Titania $50 not to tell anyone. Yeah, you were a real standout. I'll never forget the sight of you so keyed up you broke your own axe. Is that what Vite... Did he start this, theme of warriors losing their axes? Because Vite lost his axe, he broke his. Oscar, dang it, you didn't have to bring that up. Anyway, Ike, congrats on finishing your first mission. Welcome to the group. Everyone's alright? Then let's get going. I'm sure Mist has a nice hot meal waiting for us. Oh yeah, that was her name, Mist. The bad part about this is we can't touch the, we can't touch... What is it called? We can't touch the convoy. Because it's just going to throw us into battle after battle after battle. Which could be better. It could be quite a lot better. Oh, Titania. So this is where you've been, is it? Rise. Are you well? Yeah, my fever's completely gone. Are you sure? You still look a bit unsteady on your feet, if you ask me. Well, I've been in bed for almost a week. I doubt anyone would be in top form, even you, my friend. I certainly hope that's all it is. In any case, until you're back at full speed, you won't be doing any work. We're mercenaries, after all, and... Even the smallest lapse invites death, right? I know. My apologies to the rest of the team, then. It looks like I'll be recuperating for a while longer. It's for the best. Take your time and get fully rested and restored. You are our sole staff wielder, Rise. The harder our work, the more we depend on you to be at our sides. Thank you for your kind words. Oh, by the way, that paper you've been carrying around, is it a letter? I intended to go to town this afternoon. I can deliver it for you if you like. Oh no, this letter is for you, Titania. For me? Not more than a little while ago, I went out for a walk around the yard and... A man I've never seen before came up and gave this to me. He said, "Give this to the Red Trest Knight? The Red Trest Knight? I don't know what Trest actually means. How curious, I wonder what it is. I imagine it's a thank you letter from the people of Caldia or something, to that effect. Oh no, how dare they? Titania, what's the matter? What'd they say? They called me fat. Rise, take this letter to Oscar and tell him to prepare for combat and wait for me. Oh no, that's not a good sign. I have to go out for a moment. But Titania... I'll be right back, I'm counting on you. What on earth could that letter have said? I'm curious, what did that letter say? Everyone, come quickly! Hey, Rise! How you feeling? What is it? Why are you so agitated? Has something happened? It's Miss and Rolf. They've been taken by bandits. What? What are you talking about? The two of them went out early this morning to gather wildflowers. Sure, they're not back yet, but... Earlier, by the gate, a man asked me to deliver the letter to Titania. It was from a group of bandits, kidnappers. What are we going to do? Let me see it. Oh, if only I'd known. He didn't seem like a bad person. I get it. They're after revenge. They want retribution for the other day at the village. Caldia, was it? Taking children as hostages. What cowards. Blast. Wait, Ike. Where do you think you're going? I'm going to get missed. But no, Titania. She said she'd be right back. You're supposed to get ready and wait for her. And do you honestly think we've got time to wait? I'm going. Ike, come on. Don't be that guy. What do you think you're going to do on your own, rookie? Hold it, I'm going to. Stop, both of you. I'm going with you. Oh, come on, wait. This is crazy. Do you think you can just ignore the deputy commander's orders? And out they go, completely ignoring him. The road forks here. Well, which way do we go? How am I supposed to know that? Hold it. Are you saying you don't know where we're going? Unbelievable! You'd better learn to think before you act, you moron. Shut your mouth, Boyd. You think you can make me come on? Wow, this is turning into a real mature conversation. But both of you, this is no time to be fighting. I figured we'd find you like this. What are you two doing? So you're coming after all. It's not like you two chambermaids to be disobeying orders. What's the world coming to? Oscar, you know this road, don't you? Which way do we go? You're going to the bandit stronghold, right? It's the left fork. Got it. I'm still talking here. Let me finish what I... Come on, Oscar. Let's go, too. I guess we've no choice. So that's the kind of guy Ike is. Not sensible, but just bold and kind of stupid. Hey, you're not leaving me behind. Oh, that leaves room for a lot of character development. I'm really keen on Ike because, like, the concept of him, I think he'll develop like no other character in the series. So you came, did you, boys? Is it just you, then? You came alone. You seriously underestimate what we're capable of doing to you. Now, where's that snobby red-haired wench you ride with? Titania's not here, it's just us. All I want to know right now is whether Mist and Rolf are safe. Who's Rolf? Yeah, of course, we got him locked up safe and sound in that little shack back there. We got no problem with those brats. What we're after is a little revenge. We want the redhead and her pups, and that'd be you guys. And hurry up and let those two go. We're here, aren't we? You've got no more reason to hold them. You're here, but the red ain't. We'll just keep the brats until she arrives. Dang it. Yeah, you guys probably should have thought about this. A letter addressed specifically to her is probably for her. If you're so impatient, I guess we can start by killing you, Elps. You all ready to die? Hey, come on out. It's time to play, lads. Uh-oh. How threatening. There are so many, but we must not lose. Rise, move to the rear. If anyone gets injured, we'll need you on hand with your staff. Understood. Take him, lads. Without the red-haired knight, they're no match for us. What'd you say, you dirtbag? We'll make you regret those words. Alright, so what kind of unit is Rise? What are you? You're a priest. 10 magic. That's a great start, actually. He would be able to easily heal anyone. And he has a skill called Serenity. Halves biorhythm effects. I don't know what the biorhythm does, so... Ugh. I don't know what the biorhythm is even dependent on. It'd be nice if I had someone in the comments to tell me, but... Chances are, most of the people watching this have never played Fire Emblem before, and... Yeah. But that's okay. I'm glad to introduce you to the series. I'll just look it up. So, yeah, okay. Same units as last time. I imagine that after this next save, I know we'll stop, but right now... Oh, good, there's actually a suspend button. But we're going to go through this, because I kind of want to do this like hour sessions at a time, so I want to get you guys used to how this is going to be formatted. And not be like, oh, the first episode was 30 minutes, and then the rest are hours long, and you're like, I don't have time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that. Alright, so. First thing we do. To get Ike to use a steel sword. Oh, if he uses iron sword, he hits twice, which won't kill. If he uses a steel sword, he hits once, which won't kill. So it doesn't matter what he does. Let's see. So, what we could also do with Ike. No, we can't move that far. Nope, no one can move that far. I believe these thickets you can stand in, and they give you plus 10 avoid and plus 1 defense, which is really nice. So here's the plan. We're gonna have to take Oscar back here. He's gonna deal damage. He can't even take damage, I guess. He has to be a pre-promote. He's just too strong. If he's not, then cavaliers in this game and mounted units are just godlike. Alright, now I can run over here. Ooh, Ike's crit animation's decent, but like it's nothing like the first games, where it was like the swordmasters would just teleport around the screen, and the generals had those cool... I don't know why we stopped doing that. I don't know what happened to the cool chain general weapons. Like, if you don't remember, just I might display it on screen real quick. I find a gif of it, but like the general attack animation is probably my favorite, second favorite animation just in anything for attacks at least. Oh, sniff. Keep your chin up, Rolf. Boys aren't supposed to cry.
But I'm so scared. Aren't you scared?
Of course I am, but listen, we'll be fine. My brother will definitely come rescue us.
Yeah. I'm sure my brothers will be right there with him.
I'm sure they will too. Don't worry about it. No more crying. If you cry again, I'll slap you.
But no crying!
Okay, so looks like they're being pretty aggressive this time around. Just fine. We just gotta decide how we're gonna do this. Best thing to do would be to... No matter what we do, they can hit three people total. We could spread the damage out among us three, which is probably what I'm gonna do. I'm not gonna charge them head on because that'd be kinda stupid. Because Axe. I just called him Axe. Axe is Axe. Boyd is Boyd. Boyd will actually kill this guy if he gets both swings. So I'll let him go at it. I think our Boyd's gonna be pretty good this time around. He is an indispensable unit apparently, although I just had very bad luck with his growths, like, once again. So we just need to make sure we protect Rise here. Let's see, do they still... No, they cannot hit him. Alright. Oh, okay, Ike. Everyone's just doing very, very well. And Ike is going to be level 5, I believe. Let's see if he gets another godlike level up. Or no, level 4. He never... Magic I don't agree with. We're not going to need that, but all the other stats are fine. Boyd is probably going to level up if he kills this guy. Like, I think he might. Oh, yes, he will. The second hit's a crit. Okay, he won't level up, but he'll gain some XP. I think I'm going to start giving Oscar some XP too, just in case he's not a pre-promote. Like, I know people say pre-promotes are bad, I feel like Ike and Boyd, I should just be feeding all my XP to them. I love mounted units. Like, I have several Cavaliers in every single game I've played, but... Oh good, we can just move everyone up. Oh, she can actually talk to them, interesting. Oh, I'm sure she'd want to talk to Ike. Titania, I'm sorry, I ran off on my own without... We'll talk about it later. For the time being, keep your mind on the battle, Ike. Right. Okay, well. Not sure that was worth the talk, but hey, it was an option. Enemy phase. Let's see. Oh, one space too far, huh? In that case, I'll actually have Oscar. He has the disadvantage, but... Oh, he's not strong enough. That will not kill. But it will do a lot of damage. Unless Ike crits. Which I'm kind of afraid of. Nope, he did not. So Oscar will gain some XP after all. So the advantage to ground units over mounted units is, it's very interesting. Because usually ground units end up with more health. Like, I'd say a general will end up with more health, or a great knight, or whatever you... I guess a great knight is a mounted unit. But a general will end up with more health than a great knight most of the time, I believe. And usually they do hit a bit harder, but mounted units are still fantastic. Like, I'll take them over ground units any day. Uh-huh, alright. See, they all have their individual ranges.
don't know why that bush is glowing. What is going on with that? Is there an item in there? No, it's a heal hedge. It heals you if you stand in it, I guess. Cool. That's awesome. Alright, let's have Ike run up here. Murder this guy. Ike is a little low. Probably should have taken that into consideration, seeing as how he's in the range of another person. I think he'll only get hit by one more person, but I'm not sure how much damage that will do. We got a steel axe. Nice. No, he will not. He is out of range of everyone. Now I can have Ryze run over and get some XP for healing Ike. There we go. Let's see. We have a bandit with an iron axe, iron sword, and just another iron axe, but this one has a speed wing. Oh, he's the boss. Alright. 8 strength, 16 attack total. Nothing to fear, really. What's his... It's not as long as everyone else's. Okay, well, we'll be pretty safe as long as we have Oscar here. Tank the hit. We'll end the turn as is. Awesome. It seems like he's still, like, getting enough XP. And there we go. Ike should be able to take him out without a problem. Simple enough. No, before we do that, heal him up. Because if you might not understand, if you're kind of new to this series, it's best to have your priests heal as much as they can, even if it's a little bit of health that you don't need, because they'll get XP for it. And unless you're just running low on healing staves, then go for it, because the higher level they are, the better they'll get. I was avidly surprised when I hit, when I was playing Conquest, and at least hit 20, and I promoted her. I don't remember what I promoted her to. Was it strategist? Tactician? I don't remember what it's called. But anyway, I realized she gained, access to tomes, and her magic stat is so ridiculous, she just walks around the battlefield one-shotting people. And I often use her more as an offensive unit than a defensive one, and I was so happy when I just saw those stats rise like that. Let's see, what kind of weapon does this guy have? He has an axe. How much XP do you have, Boyd? 65, 67. Alright, I'll have Boyd take out this guy. If he can. Jeez. It's a low hit chance, but what can he do? If he isn't, then Ike will. No, it won't be a problem. Nope, we got him. We've been really, really lucky. We haven't missed a single swing yet. He's very close to leveling up. There is a bonus XP system in this game, which I did not know about till I was told a little bit ago, and apparently it can make or break some of these characters or chapters entirely. Okay, by the way, we can look at the options now. Individual. Oh, we can turn on and off individual animations. I always turn the priest animations off because there's no reason to see them. They just raise up their staff. Combat camera. Game speed fast, please. Message speed fast, maximum. Grid thickness, I like it a bit thicker, so that way I can kind of see what's going on. Combat window detailed, huh. Wonder what that's like. Help window, captions off, guide window, screen, auto end turns, unit facing off. Okay, yeah, that's pretty much everything. Wait, did I just turn the complex window off? What did I do? Combat window, detailed. Okay, yeah, it is on detailed. Interesting. I guess it just doesn't count towards healing. So we have certain things we can do. We should probably use this healing hedge to our advantage. Because no one's going to be able to... Well, actually, we all can run up to him and hit him. But I don't know if killing him will be the end of it.
What the hell is AS?
What did it add? So it added HP, attack... Alright, we already knew that. Defense... Hit... Okay, yeah, there's a lot of stuff on there we don't need to know, so I'm going to turn that off real quick. Just kind of... Yeah. So what level is Ike? Ike is level 4, about to be 5. So what we can do... She will kill him, even with her lowest axe. And if him run over... Deal 8 damage total with a chance of critting. Very low chance. Now, I don't know if Boyd can move that far. He can. He totally can, which is fine by me. How much damage? 9. 12 total. Okay. So now we can have Boyd run up and hit him. See, 94 XP. Sorry, I'm doing a bit of micromanagement right now. It's just how I play the game. Okay, so. Now, Boyd run up, hit him. Hopefully, he lands it. There we go. I think that'll have Boyd level up. There we... Yep. Come on, good stat growth. So I want to have a good Boyd this time around. Yes! Perfect. And now, to finish the job.
Will you let the two of them go now?
Sure, you can have- he looks like Greil. He looks like a really creepy rape Greil. Like rapist Greil. It's creepy. Sure, you can have them both. If you can beat me, that is.
If you can beat me, that is, walks up and stabs him. Oh, I wasn't ready yet. I wasn't ready. This can't be. I don't deserve to lose to cell swords like you.
Well. You should have been ready then. My body was ready, yours wasn't. Alright then. Let's see what Ike does.
I feel like he's lacking a bit in strength, but I don't know, to be honest. We got a speed wing though, which is huge. Alright, somehow we did it.
Somehow? What do you mean, somehow? We did it because we're better than them. Boyd, calm yourself. What you did was in direct defiance of the orders I explicitly gave you. How it all turned out is another issue altogether. Deputy Commander, I take full responsibility. The failure is mine. Accept our apologies. Oscar, Rise, what am I supposed to do with you two? Sigh. I think I'll leave you two to the Commander... He'll know how to handle you now. He'll know how to handle you, I'm sure. Now let's find Mist and Rolf. According to the bandit chief, they're in the shack back.
Eek.
What, Mist? Oh, come on. Just a bandit man we forgot about?
Please, let us go. I said let us go.
Who the hell is that in the forest? I see someone way out there. Who is that?
Brother, everyone, calm down. Or wait, brother, everyone, you came.
Oh, I'm scared. I don't... Rolf. Oscar, help me.
Rolf, I'm here too. I'll throw my axe at them. Hopefully I don't miss.
Boyd just starts crying. Stop crying. You don't need to worry. We're gonna get you out of there. That's right. Buck up, buddy. I'll try.
You harm either of them and I'll see you dead.
Well then.
Ike is very aggressive. Shut up. Shut your stinking trap. If you want these two alive, you'll throw down your weapons. If you don't, I'll start with the girl.
Eek, no.
Stop. Wait.
Huh?
Yeah?
I'm putting down my weapons, see? Oh, is that an ally over there? And that's why she's... Smart move, wench. Deputy Commander. We're here to save them. Now, all of you back off.
Okay. Dang. This stinks.
Heh heh. Alright, so now you're all unarmed. Which means all you can do is watch me while I gut this whiny brat like a fatling pig.
Ugh.
Oh no.
What? Oh, is this God Archer? Is this Shinon? Was that Shinon over there? I don't remember. Rolf, can you hear me? Miss, is Rolf... Is he... He's fine. He just fainted. There's not a scratch on him. Whew, don't do that to me. Well, I'm just glad to see you're both alive and well. You're both so brave. Yep, thanks. This guy's dead. This arrow, who shot it? Ah, it is. It's totally him. So this guy is regarded by many people to be the best archer in the Fire Emblem series, as where archers seem to be one of the most meh units in the entire series. By that I mean, like, they're not very necessary to have, and they're cool to have there, but they don't, like, and they have their uses and spots. It's just, usually mages have outclassed them in every single way. But there's a few exceptions, one of them being Shinon, which is a pre-promote, I believe, god-tier archer. A single arrow right between the eyes? Who else can make a shot like that? No one, that's who. That voice. Ah, it is. I can't think of a voice to give him. Like, I never... When he talks in my head, he has such a strange voice. He's like... Don't you children owe me a little gratitude? I just saved your lives. Deputy Commander, Shannon, haha. Or Shinon, Shannon, Shinon, haha. You're both so cruel. With this armor on, you know I can't run that fast. Shinon, Gatry. Sounds like a French name. So that's where you went to, Tanya. Of course, I knew we'd need reinforcements. I'm glad it wasn't a waste of time. Good thing it wasn't a waste of time, right? Right, Deputy Commander? I'm still gonna be punished from this, aren't I? And she's like, yep. Like, what do I have to do? You have to go back and play Phoenix. You have to go back and play Phoenix easy mode in Fates 11 times. He's like, no. No, don't make me. Well done, both of you. In the end, I got to feather someone, so it was worth the rush. All I did was... Sweat, that was hard work. That's me, like, every time I go outside to get the mail. It's so hard. Guys, you don't even know. Brother. Miss, you did well, sis. You must have been frightened. I never stopped believing. I knew that you and the others would come and rescue us. I knew you'd come, so I was fine. Really? That's an improvement on your usual sobbing and nose running. You jerk. I'm the jerk. You see how much of a jerk you are to Boyd? Well, seeing as our age, which is, I can't directly tell, it could be because she actually really likes Boyd, and that's why she's making so much fun of him, but I don't know. You jerk. My nose does not run. Alright, come on, let's head home. My goodness, what a day this has been. Alright, so I'm gonna end this episode here. If you did enjoy it, please leave a like, it would help me out a lot, and subscribe for more content. I normally don't like saying subscribe at the end of videos, but I'm going to say it this time in the first episode, and I probably won't say it ever again. But yes, please leave a like, and subscribing shows me that people want more content of a specific type. If you have any questions, comments, concerns, or just general tips you want to give me, leave it down in the comment section below. At the moment, I can always respond to pretty much all of them. So I will catch you guys later. Thank you and have a wonderful day. Riding out.